Well, this is me cooking. This is me cooking my first ever puri. All the dough myself. Did the old dip it in the ghee. Bought the ghee from Dal and Puri down in Pemio. And now here it is. On its way to being cooked. For those who don't know what that is, what puri is, it's fried bread. You know how you get your chapatis and rotis, whatever. And it's the other thing. Naan bread. Well, this is the fried sort of version of it. And really thin. Fried and ghee, which is clarified butter, for those of you guys who don't know. And I'm with my fork one. This is my fourth one. And the first one didn't look so brown because I don't, you know, it's got to look a bit golden brown, but didn't, because I didn't have it high enough. And I think I put it in too soon, but the rest.
Check that out. That is my fourth chapati.
But, Rogers. Oh, puri. You know what I mean. Anyway, I'm just taking a break from script writing because I've been writing hard out the last 2 weeks. So much so that my brain's right at the moment. And I've just got really worn out, so I thought I'd better take a break before I make silly, silly pieces of writing happen on the computer. That's what it's for. See, even I'm mumbling because my brain's so fried. Sorry about the noise up here, the fan's going, because it's sort of, otherwise it'll get all oily in here, and it is actually on my dirty in the window. So, on the other side, I've got Dal cooking, my first ever Dal as well. We're looking in the pantry for some penny towels, and I've found some mangoes. Yay and behold, that's what I'm putting in there, dried mangoes. Freaking tastes awesome. Ready? Tastes beautiful in Dal. Dried mangoes, they've released the flavor when it's being cooked. Yay. I think I better turn up the heat a bit, I think I put it too low. So it's going to be a bit longer to cook it. And if the heat's too low, as you guys would know with chips and fish, what happens, it soaks into the water, into the food, like into the batter or into the chips, and it tastes a bit oily when you eat the food. Now with this, when you have the heat high, doesn't penetrate, it just hits it out. It starts frying rather than going into the actual food, into the raw food. Yeah, you can nearly halfway through this. Once I finish, I'll upload it up. You guys can, well, then you'll be watching it right now. Okay. Quite pleased with myself. I've been able to put out nearly around 60 pages of script in 2 weeks. As you know, I work full time, so it's basically any spare moment I have, I've been using it. As well as, you know, working on my graphic novel, because every time my brain sort of gets a bit frozen, I start doing the graphic novel. So that's up to about, right down, probably about 2-3 hours away from the 23rd page, which is this part of the second chapter. So I would have the second chapter finished hopefully by tonight or tomorrow. There's 23 pages of chapter I put in there, and I put one as a cover for page, as a separator, so I've got 24 pages. So it's, it's mostly you need 24 pages to make it even numbers. But I only use 2.3 and then mock up another one as a chapter introduction. I worked that I've done about 625 hours on the two chapters. That works out to be 16 weeks in total. It's a lot of It's about, what, 4 months I've spent so far on this thing. All up. It takes me 15 hours a page. I guess some people look at it on the page and they go, oh yeah, it's easy, but I've got a certain style I can keep. It may look easy, but it takes a lot of time and a lot of effort. The worst thing with the eyes, slight variance in the eyes look horrible. Last night, the other night I just spent, well, it must be last night, yeah, last night, I think I spent about an hour just in the eyes. And it still didn't look right.
Otherwise, so here's a chef.